How's it going, guys? Me, David here for another shame. Hold on, I got the door cracked open. I just noticed it. There you go. And I'm here for another shave. And today I'm getting to try out another new razor. Now this is a little bit more of a popular razor, a little bit more critically acclaimed, so to speak. A lot of people are jumping on these, much in part based because of Christopher David Bailey. He got his hands on one of these and he's really enjoyed the results. Therefore, you know, when Bailey likes something, that shit catches fire. So I got myself right here a charcoal razor. Now this is not mine. I am borrowing it from a friend of mine. He's actually not a big fan of how it shaves. So I'm pretty interested in seeing how it shaves. I don't know very many people that have them. I know people, but I haven't had conversations with people that have them. So it's going to be my first real experience with it. I don't know much to do about anything with it. It's a brass razor, all machined by one individual, all completely done top to bottom, from handle design to head design. Everything's done by one man. And I really like that. You know, I'm a huge fan of the whole artisan movement in terms of the soap. And of course, I'm a huge fan of all the artisans in general, from the brush makers to razor makers. I really appreciate the work they do. It really makes the hobby fun. So I'm excited to use this. Today I'm going to be using a soap from one of the newer soap makers on the social media scene. She has been making soap for a while. Her name is Vita Perez. I'm going to be using Olea Soapworks Empire. This is not going to be the normal release packaging. This is just one that she sent me to try out. I'm really excited about it. She makes some awesome soap. I tested out one of her first runs of shaving soaps that she was introducing to the community. I recommended some things and she just did a hell of a job. And I really like her stuff, so this is the first time I'm using this particular soap. It showed up a couple weeks ago, and I've just been a little busy, so I haven't got to use it. It smells amazing. This Empire scent is that's fire right there. That's excellent shit, so I'm really excited about that. I remember reading the scent description on Instagram, and I was like, I need this in my life. So I'll have the scent description down below. I forgot it offhand. I've been planning on doing this video all day, but then I finally get home and I just space out. So it's 11 o'clock at night and I was like, damn, I really needed to get this damn video in today. I really wanted to get this video in today. So I'm a little unprepared. I kind of just hopped up. I was like, oh shit, I better hurry up. So, and here I am. So I needed a shave. I've been itching to use this damn charcoal razor, but you know, life happens and you just kind of get a little distracted. So here we go. This all smells fantastic, dude. I love the scent. So we're gonna go into a face lather. I'm gonna wet my face a little bit here. Get a little bit of, don't need a whole lot. Look at that. See, magic happens. She has a hell of a soap. This is my first time you guys are seeing me use it. The first time I didn't use it on a video. She asked me not to because it was, you know, it was a little tester. She wanted to make sure that her formula was really good when she was going to start selling it to the Facebook community. And, you know, I really appreciate her respecting my opinion enough to get me to test that initial batch when she started popping up on the groups. And as you can see, it's good shit. This is really, really good soap. Like, I look forward to seeing what else she comes up with. So here we go. First pass with the charcoal razor. And this is the level 2. So this is supposed to be their medium aggressive. There's their mild, their medium, and there's aggressive. This is the level 2. Okay, first thing that I noticed, aside from the fact that it's a gorgeous razor, during this first pass, a lot of chatter from the blade. So, more than I expected. Usually on these little bit more of a heavy-duty, high-end razors, they're usually locked in a bit tighter, so there's a lot of chatter. That's not a negative thing, it's just something that I noticed. Here we go. Real smooth the first pass. I definitely don't have a complaint with the performance after that initial one. So, if you're familiar with the above the tie razors, my favorite above the tie razor is the R1. That is the standard bar, medium aggressive one. The open comb is significantly more aggressive in my opinion. So in like a case like that, there is a higher end of the spectrum when it comes to the medium aggressive, and there's the lower, just like middle class. There's the lower middle class and the upper middle class. I like the lower middle class in terms of aggressiveness. If I'm gonna go with a daily shaver, something expensive and whatnot, you know, I want the option to be able to use that shit every day. This one seems, after that first pass, I think is going to fit into that lower middle aggressive, the lower middle aggressiveness, so to speak. So it's not a mild razor. I feel the blade well enough, but it doesn't feel like it's, again, it feels closer to the R1 as opposed to the R2. And if you've used them before, you know what I'm talking about. If you haven't, my apologies. I try to give examples to what it compares to, but that's kind of the best I can do right now. Me personally, I would prefer a little bit longer of a handle, just a touch longer. But you know, when you order your own, you have option, you have handle options. So I started to notice the chatter, the blade being a little wiggly. Not wiggly, because again, I don't want to make it seem like it's shifting, but I do feel that there's a little play in the razor. Oh, and I'm using a Pole Silver Super Iridium. So a lot of feedback, which is nice. But again, I do know you could feel a little bit of the chatter. Again, with these premium razors, that is one thing that I would prefer. I would prefer that blade feels a little bit more rigid. At least that's something that I look for in the high-end razors. Again, I've used about 5 to 6 different aggression levels, I think, on the Wolfman. No matter how aggressive that I've used, it always feels super solid locked in. Same thing with the one blade and even the above the tie razors. I feel that they're really stiff. This one doesn't completely feel that way. A lot of blade exposure. So I don't know if maybe the top cap being a little smaller lands that. I don't know what it is. I'm not really sure. But again, you hear it in all that feedback, and that's something you don't get when you use like a Wolfman or a one blade razor. But as long as it gives a good shave, I can forgive it. You know, just again, what I'm looking for in that premium set. Even the Paradigm, which I wasn't a huge fan of because it's just way too damn aggressive. The blade felt really locked in. So, third and final pass. Really flying through this shave. Oleo Soapworks. Awesome shit, dude. Keep an eye on. Follow Vita on Instagram. She's pretty active on Instagram, showing the products she's coming out with when she gets her labels in, the whole deal. This soap, man, in this next year, if she could continue to produce 9 cents like this, she's gonna blow up. Cause she has the product. This soap, it's ridiculous. Great, great soap. And I don't know how long she's been doing soaps in general, but this shave soap is a shave soap from of somebody that seems to me that has a lot of experience in soap making. It's pretty badass. Which I'll feature one of her soaps, like in its own video, when I buy one with like the legit packaging, so you guys get the real whole retail experience like that. That's a BBS shave, man. The proof is in the pudding. And again, even though I was a little thrown off by that chatter of the blade on this razor, it shaved great. The Pulse Silver blade did exactly what I expected to do. And, you know, that's the sign of a good razor. Something that I felt the problem with the Paradigm razor, it's so aggressive. In order to get a great shave from that, your technique is going to be responsible with the great shave. Because if you have poor technique, you're going to chop yourself to pieces. So if you give yourself a great shave with that Paradigm razor, it's because your technique is solid. I think when you make a razor that aggressive, you kind of take away the responsibility of the razor head design and put the responsibility of a good shave on the shaver itself. With something like this, it's a little bit more of that medium aggressive range. I feel that the head design takes into effect a little bit more what's going on. And it did the job. Again, even with that chatter, which was, again, a little odd for me and when you come to the premium razors, it gave a hell of a shave. There's not much to it. I'm going to use this a few more times this week. Probably be the razor I use exclusively. And I'll probably even drop other blades that I like. I love the Pulse Silver, some of my favorite blades. But I'll go ahead and drop a Silver Blue in there. And then I'll probably go ahead and also put in a Persona Lab Blue. So those are some of my favorite razors. I'll probably go through all those mix. Get it through the paces and really get a good idea for what it is. I will give my final thoughts video on that Paradigm razor, so keep a lookout for that. Again, just got a little busy this week, so haven't done that yet. But so, final thoughts on the Paradigm razor, final thoughts on the charcoal. First impressions after this first use, the charcoal razor is pretty damn nice. Again, it's a beautiful looking razor. I was just hoping it performed, and after that first one, it seems to. Again, I'm going to try it out with different blades so you guys have a good idea of what's going on. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Pretty quick and easy video today. I appreciate you guys for watching. If you enjoyed it, go ahead and like, share, subscribe, and I will catch you guys on the next one.